runs. So we've got the 8-4-10 today. Heading off to pick up one of our purchases off the neighbours. Machine on. The shop will know, sort of saying we need to make a decision on them tractors because they've got other people interested now in them. It's still in our yard. So between the 155 and 7530 now. Sort of leaning more towards 7530 at the moment. Horsepower to take over a lot of this tractor's duties should it need to. We'll never replace what this thing can do in sheer pull and force. So this particular neighbour has decided to give up the baling job. She's left the dormant for us. He's selling his old baler and his chaser. I'm certainly not going to turn down the chance to take these on. That's a bit more scoop. And currently this tractor is the only one we've got while operating the bale we're about to pick up. So logically it'd be a good idea to have a second one what could do it as well. Said he wouldn't be about. But we knew where the baler was going to be. I decided to buy his old Heston baler off him. Didn't want a lot of money for it. So it made sense for us to go for it. Cart this back first. I put that in there last year. Squeeze. this one back. Attempt to do our hay with this, to be fair, that was the thought behind it. More in a bale, less bales, easier to stack than round ones, less waste of space. Same with the straw, better use of storage space in the shed. Obviously we can't do silage, but looks like I think we'll wrap it. Don't dread to think what the bales would weigh, to be fair. Too long for usage, use it, but it's definitely 2 weeks away. I've got everything ready to cut for hay yet. The straw is definitely a little way off. Fertilizer on them grass fields as well. Seems a long way in a 40k tractor. Not going to take this one to pick the chaser up. Do keep toying with the idea of putting us a new barn up down here. Just not sure where we'd put it at the moment. Sheds are sort of a throwback from when we used to do our bulk silage. He wants these out of his way, so we've got to go and get both of them. Rapers out of flower. The only thing we've got to buy to go with this chaser is a front push bar, because he's never had one. Get one made, one or the other. think we're going to end up bailing quite a bit of straw up this way. Potentially oak straw. All these fields into the left oats apparently this year. Our field sort of finish on the right here at the moment. When we leave here, we'll go back around the other way and have a look at our spring barley, what went in behind the muck. This thing should speed the whole process up for us, hopefully. Bit longer way around this way, but we'll get a chance to look at some of the other fields. There's a lot of barley up the top here to bale, I do know. He's already asked us about taking that on for him. He wants to concentrate more on his pigs, to be fair. He's not interested in baling. Fields on the hillside in front of us, we've got a contract now. Going up there. So we're working in with someone doing some of the work on them. We'll be the ones combining them. I think they go combine and we've done the drilling up there. At least the owner hasn't asked us to combine them for him this year. As I did say that we would be pretty stretched with our combine to do them as well. Spring barley is looking good. Start to come down here, sort of where our land starts here on the left. Silage ground has been done in there, as you can see. That's where the cattle yard is, that's where the bales are stacked. left here. It's now ours. That's a bit of a longer way around that way. Gave us a chance just to check things. Kind of thinking if chap we've just got the size going to pigs in a bigger way, we might actually come out of them. Very marginal for us, especially now we've expanded the cattle herd to the size we have. Shed. That'll do us for this video. So all our machinery is back here now. Everything is ready to go. Shit is alright, but it's just so tight to get new stuff into. As you can see with the staunches and everything, it's an absolute nightmare for machinery. But that's where I'll be leaving this video. So for now, I'll say thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you again in the next one. Goodbye for now.